And there she is, the LM2500 on the test stand, ready for a test run. It's test day. It's minus 15 Celsius outside and it's snowing. We're gonna heat up and melt a lot of that snow with this engine. Now I've seen the data plates of LM2500s that state 28,500 horsepower. I've seen them at 34,800, and I'm sure later versions have even more power. But originally, it was gonna be a 25,000 horsepower output, and it's been updated and hot rodded from then by the manufacturer. Good old General Electric. It's a beautiful job done by Al and the boys. Big Al and his team of jet engine technicians. Look at that thing. Beautiful. Okay, that noise you hear is our recirculation pump of liquid propane. And that big white tank there, despite what some thieving jet fuel hoaxer idiots have put in their comments and their captions, that is not full of compressed air. That is full of liquid propane gas. We pass it through this vaporizer, which is burning propane in a heat exchanger. We expose the propane, the liquid propane, to the heat. It becomes gaseous propane that gets fed through this line here. And then that silver hard insulated line that we see behind this container right there. It goes into the building right where the liquid fuel lines also do. That's our generator over there because we don't have grid power. Now the main fuel valve is underneath this protective cover. We can see a little bit of it there. It's got a manual purge valve right there. What we need to do is we need to purge out the liquid propane from the line so it doesn't get fed into the engine. Now this is the main fuel line downstream of the valve. It's insulated and right now it's got a cap in it. We're going to remove that cap, blow out all the liquids, and then we're going to attach it here to the fuel manifold right there. It has a cap on it right now. And this hard stainless steel manifold feeds all of the 30 fuel nozzles right there. Very cool. So we've replaced the feeder lines, the pigtails we call them, that go from the fuel manifold to the fuel nozzles. And they go into the combustor liner, all 30 of them. They all burn fuel at the same time in a nice even donut shape or torus or annulus. And this thing is gonna make some serious heat. It's fabulous. So it's gonna be noisy in here when we've got the start cart running. We're feeding air into the starter. This big orange hose does handle compressed air to our air turbine starter, which is fitted to the rear of the gearbox right there. Yes. Right now the end is open, capped actually, because it's going to be fitted to Starty, our little gas turbine engine. Has an output of about 25 PSI air from this 4-inch output. 85 pounds of air per minute is the specified output of this thing. Might be a little low because it's from the 50s, but that's going to start our huge gas turbine engine right there.
Thank you.
warm up a bit and then take her up.
Well, let's see where the VSVs start to move.
Successful test run of an LM2500 to maximum RPM. Well, maximum do not exceed is 10,100. We got to 9,500. There's your first stage of the compressor turning behind the inlet guide vanes. That's beautiful, isn't it? Well, no afterburner, but it's a huge engine. So we didn't so much blow away the snow, we warmed up the world. Jet wash alley's quite comfortable right now, for a few minutes anyway. Thanks for watching.